Hi, my name is Coop, and in this video, I'll discuss business entities. Your role as a professional data analyst will differ greatly depending on the organization you work for. Size is a really important factor in this. At small to mid-sized companies with fewer than 250 employees, you may be asked to wear many hats because the work will be divided between a smaller number of analysts. At larger companies, you may have a very defined role with a smaller variety of tasks to perform. At the highest level, companies are categorized by their ownership into three sectors: the private sector, the public sector, and the nonprofit sector. The private sector is the part of the economy that is owned and operated for profit by private individuals and groups, rather than the government. 91% of working Americans are currently employed in this sector. The largest private sector employer in the world is Walmart, with 2.1 million workers worldwide. There are four common structures of privately held organizations: the sole proprietorship, the partnership, the limited liability company, and the corporation. Sole proprietorships are owned by a single individual, and there is no legal distinction between the company and the owner. This means that the owner has maximum control of the company, but is also responsible for any debt or legal liability that the company incurs. Partnerships are like sole proprietorships, but they can have multiple owners. That often means more creative dynamism, but a greater risk of a catastrophic split in the company's vision. If a partner dies or withdraws, the company is often liquidated. Limited liability companies, commonly called LLCs, give the advantage of limiting the owner's responsibility for debts and legal liabilities. So, depending on the state laws involved, owners are shielded from suits and debt claims against the company. This is relatively new in the US, but more established in some other countries. The disadvantage of this kind of firm is that it cannot sell shares of its stock, making it harder to raise cash. Corporations are the fourth kind of private sector entity, the only one that isn't linked to a particular person. Legally speaking, a corporation is itself a person, because it can enter contracts. There are several kinds of corporations which I won't go into here, but you should know that there are both privately held and publicly held corporations. Privately held companies rely on a select few investors to raise funding, and you can't buy their shares on the stock market. Because of this, they retain greater organizational control. Once a company decides to sell its shares on the open market, it becomes a publicly traded company, subject to certain rules about financial transparency. The company can now sell shares to raise cash for projects, but it's also under a lot of pressure to perform well and keep its stock price up. That's all for the private sector. Another 9% of working Americans are employed in the public sector, the part of the economy owned by government institutions. For example, the Forestry Service, the Energy Department, and various social services. Government work is much different from work in the private sector. It tends to provide good retirement benefits, but also often has limited opportunities for professional growth. It also tends to have stricter requirements for data security. Analysts may be issued a work laptop that keeps track of all user behavior. The smallest sector is the nonprofit or civic sector. Nonprofits are special organizations that are exempt from income tax requirements, so any money they receive is not taxed. However, employees of nonprofits are not exempt from income tax. In return for their tax-exempt status, these organizations are subject to more legal oversight. Also, nonprofits are generally focused on social good, so they have to continually prove that they are providing a benefit to society in order to build public confidence and secure funding. Some examples of nonprofits are environmental organizations, after-school programs, think tanks, and even churches. Working for a nonprofit can be a great way to give back to those in need and work with passionate people. But since these organizations tend to be dependent on donations for their income, they tend to pay their employees significantly less than companies in the private sector. You're most likely to work in the private sector, so you should know the basics of organizational structure and hierarchy. Private businesses are typically arranged hierarchically, with people at each level organizing the tasks of the people directly underneath them. I'm going to describe the structure of a very large company, though at smaller companies, many of these roles may not exist. We'll start at the top of the hierarchy. This is the C-suite, so-called because all the most senior titles start with chief. The CEO is the chief executive officer, the highest-ranking member of the company. You've probably seen them in the news a lot, and that's because they are usually the public face of the company. The CEO has a huge ability to influence the company's values, strategy, culture, and morale. The COO, Chief Operating Officer, is usually the second in command who oversees the entire day-to-day functions of the company. The CFO, Chief Financial Officer, ensures the company is managing its resources well and reporting its finances accurately, as per legal requirements. Though the CEO is at the top of the chain of command, they still have a boss. They're accountable to the board of directors, which corporations are required to have by law. The board represents the interests of shareholders, the people who buy stock in the company. Ideally, these separate parties act as checks and balances to keep a company profitable and ethical. Below the C-suite are vice presidents, the second highest level of management. They oversee functional areas of the company that are often known as departments. Sales is a department, as are marketing and human resources. Departments are split into divisions that handle specific tasks in those categories. For example, the marketing department may contain divisions for branding and strategy, content marketing, and market research. Each of these divisions will have a director who oversees the strategy of that division and coordinates it with other parts of the company. Within a division are teams. This is where you come in. In your first data analyst job, you will start off in a team. You, the junior analyst, will be accountable to the team's manager and senior analysts on the team. These people can be seen as your mentors, challenging you to grow in your abilities. After all, every senior analyst was once a junior analyst, and many managers were once analysts themselves, distinguishing themselves over the years as competent leaders. Now, not all companies are this hierarchical. Looser and flatter organizational structures are growing in popularity, and many companies have some number of cross-functional teams where people from totally different fields work together. The key takeaway from all of this is that companies are highly complex ecosystems. With so many people, even the most successful companies have their share of mystery, frustration, and miscommunication. Apart from being a good data analyst, part of your job will be about understanding your role and the roles of those around you. That skill will make you a good team player and a better person in general.